The look.
Again, the most enjoyable aspect of my job, all 31 or 32 years of it, was working with students, particularly in activities and leadership. In 1990, the student body selected Yvette Cabrera as ASB president. Was she ever the right person at the right time for this position? Her leadership skills were unsurpassed. Foremost, she led the student fight against closure of DP. What a fireball she was. Looking at her, you wouldn't believe that. She's bright, articulate, and she genuinely cared for the entire student body. In addition to her responsibilities as ASB president, Yvette was very much involved in MESA, which is Mathematics, Engineering, Science Achievement Club, co-captain of the song leaders, NHS CSF member for 4 years. How you did it, I do not know. She was also honored with the Hewlett-Packard Company Pursuit of Excellence Award. This was in her time at DP. Her success as a charger was only the beginning. She has since gone on to an award-winning career as an investigative journalist. During this time, she met and married an equally successful award-winning photographer, Daniel Anderson. Daniel's out there, I know. There he is. Together, they have traveled the country and many places throughout the world on assignments. It's hard to believe what this young lady has done. She has covered unbelievable tragedies, loss, injustice, and corruption. Yet both Yvette and Daniel continue to exude the optimism and hope for this world despite all they have witnessed and covered. It is my honor to introduce Hall of Fame inductee Yvette Cabrera.
Wow, I'm gonna cry. Good evening. This honor means so much to me, partially because I'm being inducted alongside some of my heroes, including Mr. Meister, but as well as other people like the courageous Amy Foose. There are so many people who came before me who I admire. But also because I look back now at my years at DP and they really did shape who I am. I am the daughter of immigrants who came from Mexico with very little in terms of financial means, but with so much hope and drive and a very strong work ethic. I feel very fortunate to have had two amazing parents. My mother's here in the audience. They really set the example for me. Spanish was my first language. We worked alongside my parents. My father was a gardener. My mom cleaned homes, then later started her own business. And one of the lessons that she taught me was, if you work hard, if you get good grades, if you get an education, you will accomplish so much in your life. And I really took that lesson to heart and made education, that was my passion. I knew it would be my way up. But that, even though in those days especially, I felt like, you know, all the odds were stacked against me. I didn't know how I was gonna pay for college. I knew I wanted to go to college. I think back now and I see the most important lesson back then was that when all the odds are stacked against you, that's when you fight the most. And that was a crucial lesson at DP, particularly our junior year when we found out that DP was going to close. And you can imagine heading into our senior year, the thought of going to San Marcos High School for our senior year was, we were not liking that idea. So that was part of what drove us to get involved with the fight to keep DP open. And there were so many people that we had to thank for that. All the parents and community members that really did all the hard work. We had the fun part of going to the school board and dumping a box of signatures and telling them we wanted our school to stay open, and we went to San Marcos and protested. But really, the parents are the ones who led that drive and set the example for us. But I think back now to that effort, it really taught us to see beyond ourselves, to look at the larger community, and it gave us something to fight for. And fortunately, DP stayed open, and we went into our senior year, I think, very grateful that we had, it wasn't just that the doors stayed open, but that we had a community of support, people like Mr. Meister and Phyllis Lenker and John Lenker and Maria Vega, and so many amazing people surrounding us who really gave us the opportunity to lead ourselves. We became leaders by watching them, but they also gave us the opportunity to take chances. And yes, we made mistakes, but most of the time, I think we did a pretty good job. And we had an amazing year. And I look back now at some of my classmates, they're accountants. They're people like Amir Abushayir, who's got this amazing engineering academy. And I think, what if that hadn't happened? A lot of that was because we fought to keep DP open. And that's part of the Charger spirit. That really is. I cover criminal justice issues now. I write a lot of stories about young men and young boys and girls who a lot of people have given up on. And I think if they had had just a little bit of the Charger love that we had, that maybe the world would be a different place. So thank you for this honor. It really means so much. And thank you, Mr. Meister, for being such a hero to so many of us.